Hello guys, so we are going into the next one. We are talking about the normal interpolation of data. So the normal interpolation of data, you got some objective that we'll be covering into this particular exercise, or sorry, this particular lecture. So the first one, we are going to study the concept of normal interpolation of data, and then we are going to focus on how you can estimate, how you want to calculate the area under curve in our data analysis. So we got the area under curve, for example, here. Wait, I'm going to show you some ideas here. So we got the normal distributions of data based on our histogram and so on. So we want to estimate the area under curve, any area under this curve. So you must already understand now. So the area under curve also is being associated is actually with the z-score just now. So all of the z-score is already being all of the x or the pure variable is already being transferred into the z score. So we are going to use this application from the previous lecture. Okay, so we need to understand about the how to calculate the area under curve in the normal distributions of data. So for you to estimate the area under curve, you need the normal tabulations of data tables, normal tabulations of data table, normal tabulations of data, normal standard tabulations of data tables. So whatever it is actually a table. So for example, you got a table. So I'm going to show you the table after this. So the table indicate the z is equal to 1.23. So we are going to estimate what is actually the area that the statisticians is already calculated before based on the z is equal to 1.23. It's very simple. So 1.2, we find the z first. Okay, we find the z first. And then the 1.2 is actually here. 1.2. You can see the 1.2 here. And then you know that 1.2, we got another excess items here. We call it as a 3. So where you want to find the 3? The 3 is actually on the other column. You need to focus on the 3. You refer to the 3 or so, which is the intersections of the 1.2 and 1.3. We got the 0.309. So remember, the question is kiri zak, which is the left. The left of the z. So if the left of the z, that means I got this thing, I got this normal tabulation data is equal to 0. 1.23 is here. Left, where is it? It's actually all of this area. You see, all of the areas that I've been shedding it. I've been shedding it. Okay, so where is it? So of course, it is here. See, similarly, like I explained before. So you got 0.307 is actually only a portion of this. A portion of this. So what about this one? This one is actually 0.5, because I'm talking to you before. All of these is actually estimated and area under curve is equal to 1. So if we derive as 1 everything, so on the left side will be 0.5, on the right side will be 0.5. So this one is actually 0.5 straight away. How I know is 0.5 because the theoretical speaking is like that. You've got a center is equal to 0. You got everything inside that curve is 1. So if you divide something into the half, you got 50 here, 50 there. So this one is another 50, and then this one is another something that we already justified on the 1, 2, 3 z score. So 1, 2, 3 z score using the z tabulation table. So z tabulation table indicates 0.309. So we plus the 0.307 with the 0.5, we got 0.8907. So that is our area under curve for the z is equal to 1.3 on the left side. So you need to focus, you need to understand how to draw the z tabulation figures, which is this one. You need to know how to draw. As long as you know how to draw, then you will pass the exam. Okay, the next one will actually simulate something that you need to calculate the area under curve on the normal tabulation tables that located left 0.23. So if I don't want to see this, so I can still imagine it's like this, minus 2.73. Of course, it's on the left side. Why? Because it's minus. So it said that here, terletak di kiri, which is located on the left side. Of course, it will be here, correct? So it will be here on the z normal, on the z tabulation. So how we want to calculate? Of course, you calculate using the normal tabulation table, normal tabulation table on the z score. So 2.73, where you want to find this 0.23? Of course, you need to refer to the table. You find the z here on this specific rows, and then you find 3 on this specific column, and then you find the intersection of it. So you got the intersection is equal to 0.498. So 0.498 is actually the 2.73 is equal. We got this one. However, remember that this is our normal tabulation curve. We got here is 0. We got here is minus 2.73. It's actually located on the left side of it. So we might want to consider to use the excess of it. So we got this one, everything here is 0.5. So you minus 0.5 with this one, sorry, you minus 0.5 with this one, you got this one. So how you want to know this one? Of course, I know this one, right? I know this one. This side is equal to 0.4968. So I minus 0.5 with the z. With the z that I've got it from the 0 from the 2.73 is equal to 0.003. So 0032. So 0032 is actually the excess part of the peak of the end of our 2.73 on the length. Whatever it is, it's just a plus minus. It's just a something that you need to imagine first. Whether it's on the left, it's on the right, it's where you need to know. Okay, this is the examples of the exercise. I hope that you can take a moment, have a look, pause this video, and then print screenshot whatsoever. Try to answer this thing, and I'm going to share with you the answer later on. Make sure you know how to draw. The first thing I give you idea. First, you need to know how to draw the z tabulation curve. So the z tabulation curve, of course, in the middle is 0, followed by the 1 and minus 1, 1 and minus 1 standard deviation, 2 and minus 2 standard deviation, and so on. So make sure you can imagine where it will fall down. And another one that is very important, take also this idea or this table. Okay, I'm going to hide my video here. So that you can see, this is the area and the curve for the normal curve tabulation table. So you can see there is 1.96 of the z-score. So 1.96 is equivalent to actually 0.4750 of the area and the curve. So this is example that usually will be used by the public health epidemiologists, all these environmental health officers. In the end of the day, those who are learning the biostatistics before, as myself, so I'm not sure about 1.96 before, but after I'm studying these topics to clearly understand about the z curve, about the tabulations, about the how to transform the x into the z, so it's become more clearer and clearer. So happy copying this picture so that you can know what is the cross sections and the row about your data. For example, 1.32. 1.32 is equal to here actually. 1.32 is 0.466. So make sure you understand the questions here, what they want. For example, this one is located on the left of the z. This one right of the z. This one in between of the minus 0.67 and 7.18. So you need to imagine 1.83, which is on the right side, and then 0.67 on the left side. So it's actually cross-secting something. So this one, I just give some hint for you. So 1.83 something here, and then 0.67 is something here, because this one is minus 1 standard deviation, right? So it's actually cross the mean of our data. So this one is actually for the score that is tabulated normally, what is the rate. This one is very nice, the rates. So after you got, you need to sum it. You need to calculate it using the 100% of the findings that you got. So if you calculate 100% of the something that you got, so it will project the proportions of the score that you calculated. Never mind, you try it first. If you're wrong, also it's Sure, because it's just exercise, right? I can explain to you after this, and don't forget to watch the video and also attachment that I will be giving to you in the class. Okay, so welcome back, guys. So don't forget to copy this one. Okay, I give you another chance, one more, to copy this thing. I hide already my video so that you can print screen this thing. So make sure you know where is the X, and also, sorry, not X. I mean the value of the Z that you are trying to search, and then make sure you understand also the column that you need to refer for the items. Okay, hope you got it already. Okay, then the next one is the other questions also. This is the other question also. So make sure you refer to the specific question. What are they asking for? So for example, the one is asking for the Z, sorry, the area under curve, which is the between 0 and 0.77 on the Z normal tabulation standard. So normal tabulation standard here, we are talking about the table. So make sure you look into the tables, and then you can imagine where is the Z located on your data. And then they give you also here challenging questions, something like data is normally tabulated. We got the standard deviation, we got the Sorry, we got the standard deviation, we got the mean here. So of course you need to calculate the Z first. So after you calculate the Z, then you need to imagine also the 520. So 520 also need to be calculated back with the Z. So make sure you try to simulate the Z based on the previous section of our discussion. So after that also, we need to know the bilangan skor and so on based on this. So try first, because more than 520 is actually to represent something that more than the Z of the Of it, you know, more than Z of this thing. So Z of this thing will be more than here, something like that. So try to imagine first, try to answer it first, and then we are going to discuss this thing later on. Don't worry. Okay. The next one I'm going to share with you is actually the examples of we got some ideas about data on the IQ. This is just example. Okay. The mean is equal to 100. The standard deviation is equal to 16. So we want to calculate who or which one of the respondents that fall within the 125 and 140 of the IQ, of the X IQ. X is our IQ, okay? So we need to compute this thing by knowing the area and the curve first, and then we need to know the normal tabulation tables. So from the normal tabulation tables, we can estimate something we call it as the Z score. So from the Z score, then we know how many percentage those who fall within the 125 and 140 that we trying to estimate. Okay, to compute the Z score within the normal tabulation standards, we need to know also it's being associated with the normal tabulation table. So normal tabulation table, for example, this one, Hintung Z score, you need to calculate the Z score is equal to area under curve 0.4 under the area under curve, which is located at the left side of the tabulation. So left side of the tabulation is where? This is where you need to go on the inverse. You know, inverse means you need to go on the backside. Backside means that you need to go on the opposite direction. So we are going to the first one. We are going to estimate first where is our data. So we got the tabulation data here. It says that the hintung the Z, so calculate the Z score for the 0.04 area under curve. Area under curve on the standard tabulation tables located on the left tabulation. So that's mean this is our table. So 0.04 is actually your area under curve. So we know already our area under curve. We know area under curve is equal to 0.04. But what we don't know about the Z. We don't know about the Z. So we need to estimate about the Z that will be produced from this area under curve. So it's very simple. So the first one, you know that everything is actually one, correct? Everything here is one. So we minus one minus the 0.04, we got 0.96. So 0.96 is actually everything minus this thing. But you must remember, we are talking about the half of this portion. So you probably want to eliminate another 0.5 here that does not belong to this located area. So 0.96 is minus 0.5, you got 0.46, and then you need to find something that associated with 0.46. So 0.46, first thing you need to find on this data, if you can see, this data is ascending, you see, it's more increasing. So this one is 0.499. So 0.499 is equivalent to 0.45. So 0.46 is actually 0.05 here, and then 1.7 here. So actually our Z is equal to 1.75. So how you got the 1.75? You start from here. That's why I say this one is inverse. You find the area and the curve first, and then you find the Z plus the column of the Z, which is 0.05. So 1.7 plus 0.05, you got 1.75. So therefore, when you got the Z, so can you compute the X? Of course, you can compute the X. So this is the very good idea of it. Okay, sometimes you can see that the Z alpha is being used to show to the score, okay? You can see sometimes the statistician use also the Z score, which is the area of the score on the left side of the score in under the direction. Easy to say, something on the right, we call it as Z alpha. Something that we do not say alpha is not right, it's something left. Okay, something that we call it as Z alpha is already show something on the right. So that is what this slide I want to share with you. Okay, now using the normal tabulation curve, normal tabulation tables, identify the Z 0.025. So 0.025 is actually Z alpha. Lah. So the Z alpha on your right. So we got 0.025, and then we got the rest is 0.975. How I got it? 1 minus 0.025. So 1 minus 0.025, we got half of it. So minus again with the 0.5, you got 0.475. So 475 is something here. 4726 72 744 745. So 745 is something like here. So go into this row and then find out the origin of it, which is 1.9, and then don't forget also to see the intersections here on the upper side of it, which is 1.96. So the 1.96 is actually 0.025 from the area and the curve that we estimate. So actually this is the rule of thumb, if you see something 0.025, it's actually 1.96 on the Z score for the Z tabulations. So this is how about it. So how we want to apply this knowledge, okay? You must understand that we use already the IQ just now as the indicator to know about this. So we got 100 as a mean, we got 16 as the standard deviation. So now we want to identify the percentage of the people that have the IQ within 115 to 140. So in the first thing, we need to make sure that this data is normally tabulated. Let's say this one is assumed already being tabulated normally. So now we are going to convert everything that is associated with this data into the Z score. So how we want to convert into the Z score? Of course, you need to convert everything from the normal tabulations using the histogram here into the normal tabulations of data by using the Z score. We call it as the normal tabulation standard. Normal tabulation standards will be identified as follows. So this is 100, this is 115. This is normal tabulation of data for the X value. So this is the normal tabulations of data using the Z value, which is the normal tabulation standard. Normal tabulation standard that been calculated using the Z is equal to X minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. So you got this thing, 0.94 is actually something 115 here. And then you got 140 is 2.5 standard deviation, or we call it as the Z score. So this is our region, this is our area and the curve. So now we are going to estimate the area and the curve. So we got here something to do with 0.94 and something to do with 2.5. So how to estimate the 0.4 and 2.5? So the first one, we go to the 0.94. So 0.94 is actually 0.0326. So 0.0326 is something area and the curve there, and then we got the 2.5 here. 2.50 is equal to 0.438. So we plus this thing, we not plus this thing because it's located here on the 0.5 on the right side. So you must understand this is something to do with 0.32 6, and then something to do here, it will be z is equal to 0.94, and then 2.5 here. So you got the 0.4938 is something 2.5 here. So 2.5 here minus this one, you got the excess number of it. So how you got the excess number of it? It's very simple. You take the highest one, which is the 0.438, this one, minus the lowest one. So you got the